Hello, everybody. It is 5:30, and it's time for some more Dragon Wolf and V3 Killing Harmony. Last time, I got sad because we went into a virtual world. You know, that was kind of fun stuff. Weird laws of physics, I guess you could call them, in there. And also, Mew died. Yeah, Mew died. So. We're going to investigate her murder, figure out who killed her, bring that person, hopefully, to justice. I doubt we're going to do it this game, during this, session. There's usually one that we have to do for, investigation first, then we can do another one for, one or two investigation things before we can really do, an actual trial. So, here we go. Mew's cold dead body. Chapter 4. Live and let the languid world live. Deadly life. Daybreak. The sun had risen while we were inside the virtual world.
Has been discovered! Everyone, please report to the computer room!
Yeah?
Wait! You're already here!
Yeah.
Wow! I get to bring you the body discovery announcement live! Doing it live is great! Better than beer and fucking! Daddy, have you always had such a potty mouth?
Hey,
I was holding back because we already had one vulgar cast member, but now it's my turn to shine!
That's nice!
Thankfully, I am adorable, so I can get away with saying all kinds of crude stuff! Yay! I finally get to be a foul-mouthed asshole!
Yeah!
What a vulgar last word! What's wrong, Monotaro? You're just staring blankly at the body. Staring at the body. Mommy!
We barely heard the announcement as we stared at Mew, dumbfounded. We just stared at Mew's corpse.
It's terrible. Why did it end up like this?
Why?
Mew! Why?
What's going on? Why was Mew killed?
Gonta not understand either. Mew like this when Gonta wake up.
Why?
Hey! What's going on? Why this happened?
Yeah.
Well, it's obvious a murder happened.
Huh?
Murder! What do you mean? Did something happen while Gonta asleep?
No.
We weren't asleep, and that wasn't a dream. We were in the virtual world.
Hey.
Hey, where's Kaito?
Oh.
That's right, Kaito! Almost as if on cue. We heard footsteps running fast down the hallway, the sound growing louder until the door burst open. What's this all about? What was that body discovering us?
What?
No! What the? As if on cue, the game crashes.
So, Kaito, please do tell. What the heck were you doing not up on the roof? Why were you already out? Why were you already logged out, Kaito? I am very curious about this. Because I'm placing you under suspicion for killing Mew. Gotta skip through a bunch of dialogue now. Body discovery. Also, Mew's headset's off, meaning someone took that off of her. And it wasn't any of us. Mew was like that. So it only could be someone who logged out who could have taken that off. Mew, what the hell is going on here? You're too late, okay? All the others finished gasping in terror already.
Either way.
But anyway, where were you this whole time, Kaito? What were you doing? I was just taking a nap!
Huh?
Taking a nap?
You were sleeping! Gonto was sleeping too! Had strange dream! Gonto not understand anything!
As I said, that was the virtual world!
So, you logged out by yourself, and then took a nap. Without our permission.
You know...
I suddenly got logged out, but before I realized it, I was back here!
You were logged out involuntarily.
Okay. Yeah, I didn't know if it was okay to log back in, so I went back to my room and slept. And when that body discovery announcement woke me up, I rushed over here! Hey, Kaito, if you're gonna lie, then you might as well do it better. Do you think you can make that kid game more exciting with a crappy lie like that?
Hold on!
It's not a lie! I really was sleeping!
Hold on a minute. We can discuss whether or not that's a lie later. What we need to do right now is begin the investigation. We need to discover who killed Mew.
You seem ready. Well, of course you are.
Right?
One of your dear friends was killed, so it's finally time for you to see it.
Explain it however you like, Kokichi. The fact is, if we don't find out who the culprit is, we'll all be executed.
No.
But I won't let that happen. I'll find the culprit so that we can all survive.
Even if the culprit is Kaito.
Don't screw around!
What?
Now, please save your arguments for the class trial! In the meantime... The Molecula File! With this, you can even investigate a Mew's asshole! Even there? Well then, do your best! I'm certain you guys will make this turn of events very entertaining, asshole! Daddy seems to really be enjoying that dirty word.
Mommy!
Yeah. Okay, everyone, let's do this. I'll find the culprit this time, no matter what.
Hey!
What are you being so cheery about?
But...
Well, what are you sad about? You guys hated her. Not as much as you hate me, but still.
Stop it!
That's not the issue. Of course, I thought she was loud and annoying, but...
I never wanted her to die! I wanted us all to escape together!
Yes.
Mew was certainly present-spirited, but she wasn't a bad person.
Listen closely.
Believe me, I had her perform maintenance on my body, so I know very well. I want to cry, but I can't. I should have had Mew install a crying function. Huh? What are your tears cause you to short circuit?
No.
Not at all. My body is completely waterproof.
This isn't the time for that.
Gonto, no can forgive this! Gonto, never forgive this! Never forgive culprit either!
Gonto!
But Gonta never forgives self. Gonta swear to protect everyone, but Gonta failed to protect Mew. Gonta no can protect anyone again. Gonta is failure as gentleman.
I'm so tired of this awful feeling. I have to do something. I can't let this...
Shuichi!
Shuichi, don't carry the burden all by yourself!
Huh?
Listen up.
You are my sidekick! Don't forget!
Yeah.
We're gonna do it together! If we work together, we can solve this!
Ah.
No way, Jose.
What?
What?
Well, you know...
Shuichi is the most reliable person in a class trial, you know. Why would we let such an important person work together with a suspect like you?
Suspect! You're saying that if I were the culprit, Shuichi would hide the truth to protect me!
Don't screw around!
Bullshit! Don't underestimate Shuichi! He unveiled the truth about Kaede! He was the one who got her killed! Even if I was the culprit, he's the type of guy I'd see things through! But remember Kaede's class trial.
Shut up!
He saw through that, didn't he? I believe in Shuichi!
Okay.
Kaito.
You love to believe, don't you, Kaito?
You really don't.
But that belief can turn against you. Especially in this killing game, you know. I've got no idea what you're talking about! I don't get it at all! Fine, if you're gonna get all worked up over it, then me and Shuichi won't team up!
But... Don't worry about it!
It's just for now! But hearing him say all that, I can't stay quiet!
I believe in
that
you!
That said, try to get through this on your own! Clear me of suspicion with your own power! If you can be cleared.
I don't like this at all. It feels like another one of Kokichi's tricks. Of course, this is Kaido we're talking about. Nothing I say could change his mind. Regardless, there's only one thing I can do. I can't be afraid. I can't get lost now. In order to protect everyone, I have to do something. Investigation start! I'm gonna save quick. First, I should check the Monokuma file. Do I finally get to investigate on my own? Alright, the victim is the ultimate inventor, Mew Iruma. The body was discovered on the in the computer room on the fourth floor. Approximate time of death is 6:30 a.m. There are no external wounds on the body. Killed around 6:30 in the morning. The time of death happened 30 minutes before now, while we were still in the virtual world. Kokichi, what do you want? You don't have to be so wary of me. It's not like I'm gonna get in your way, Shuichi. It's just, I hate Mai so much that I tend to suspect others a lot. Kaido said he wouldn't team up with you for this case, but I can't trust those words.
So that means...
That's why I'm keeping an eye out, just in case he tries to bother you.
Keeping an eye out.
It's true!
Don't take it the wrong way, though. I'm not trying to replace Kaido with your partner, okay?
Alright!
But I'll help you as much as I can. So, where are you gonna investigate now?
What is he up to? Why is he following me? Monokuma File 4 has been added. Note how it doesn't say the cause of death. There we go. So yeah, it doesn't say the cause of death, it only says the, time of death. Of course, the Monokuma file won't give us any details that would point us directly to the killer. Hey, there's a thing there. Small bottle. There's something on the seat. It's a small bottle. I feel as though I've seen this before.
This is yours, right, Shuichi?
Huh?
Mine? No, I guess it's not yours, but it is from your lab.
Oh.
Ah, that's right. This was in the Ultimate Detective's lab.
Right?
Yeah, is that poison? So you know about this, Kokichi. Of course, because I already checked it. We are in a killing game, you know. If there's poison and tricks prepared, then of course I'd investigate them ASAP. It's not so I can use them. I check in case someone else uses them. Is that really true? Also, I forget whose seat that was.
By the way,
did you see the label on the back of this bottle?
Huh?
The label. According to the warnings here, this poison is pretty lethal. It becomes neutralized once it's mixed, so it has to be taken directly. But when it's taken directly, the victim will immediately die, even if they only sip a bit. Which means if you could get the victim's mouth open, you could kill them instantly. Can't imagine a better method of killing someone who's long dead.
By the way,
I should tell you what symptoms this poison causes. It causes a small blood vessel under the conjunctiva to explode, which makes the whites of your eyes turn blood red. Bloodshot eyes. That's important information. Well, that's everything about this poison. Am I doing a good job? You can stop here and acknowledge me as your partner.
No.
I thought I remembered you saying that you didn't want to be my partner.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Did I? Well, sometimes I lie without thinking about it.
Huh?
Seriously?
Anyway,
who brought this poison? Do you think the culprit did it? Who brought the poison? I can't be certain yet. Oh! But I do know that poison was left on that person's chair, and that person is Kokichi, who is investigating the lounge room. The lounge room which has the logout area. Alright, poison has been added. Let's investigate Mew's body quick. Mew's hands are clasped around her neck as if she were gasping for air. Her eyes are wide open in a panic. She must have suffered quite a bit.
Wow.
Oh, that's one grody face. Mew must have suffered a lot. A vulgar death fit for a vulgar bitch.
Hey!
Stop, Kokichi. Even if you're joking, that's too far.
It's nothing.
You're right. I should never speak ill of the dead, no matter how much you hated them.
Right?
Even if she was a despicable, pathetic, dirty cum toilet of a person. I suppose I'll never get Kokichi to change.
But
what's Mew's cause of death? It doesn't say that in the Monokuma file. May I? I wanted to let you know, just in case it turned out to be a clue.
By the way,
I was the first one to log out and find Mew's body. She was still wearing the helmet, and her body was contorted into this awful position. Maki logged out after I did, and she helped take off Mew's helmet. Take Mew's helmet off. And then, she was gone.
Hey.
Is that a confession?
Why?
How is that a confession? Anyway, the question is the cause of death. What caused her to suffer like this? Are we not going to look at the eyes to see if they're bloodshot? Seriously? Like, that'll tell us if she was poisoned or not by that poison. We're seriously not going to look at her eyes? Nope. Nothing about that changes. Sure, let's not look at her actual body and figure anything out. This is the device we wore on our heads to enter the virtual world. Some helmets still have their cords plugged in, others have them removed. I'm positive that they were unplugged after logging out. Ah, that's it, the cords. We were supposed to plug the two cords from the computer into our helmets. Red is for consciousness and blue is for memory. If you got those mixed up, out of curiosity, what happens if you switch the cords? I don't know. I've never done that before. Probably gets all glitchy or something. Maybe we have a vegetable.
Maybe you'll punish one with someone. Who knows? A glitch. Interesting. Okay, so we're not gonna get any details about new visor setup either. Alright, let's look at the other visor. This is a device we wore on our heads. Some helmets. Okay, so that's not going to give us anything. Alright, let's look at the computer. From what the time of death indicated in the Monokuma file, Mew was killed when we were still in the virtual world. Okay, let's start with the Monokuma. Let's see if they have it. Hello, Monofany, anything you want to say?
Hey, Monotaro, what's going on with you? This place is upsetting my stomach. No, you're endangering our entire existence as mascot characters.
Okay, Monotaro, anything you want to say there?
Mommy!
Okay, that's it. Okay, so it doesn't look like we'll be able to get any other details by looking around. Time to question people. Let's just go from right to left. So, Samugi.
It ended up like this after all. I had a bad feeling ever since I thought I saw Mew from the dining room window.
You thought you saw Mew?
Oh. Yeah, I told Suichi about it. There's a small window in the dining room. Maybe 10 minutes ago, I looked through it, and I thought I saw Mew.
Oh, so you saw Mew then?
I thought it must have been mistaken. I thought I must have been mistaken, since she should have been by the chapel.
You only say you were mistaken. So you don't have to feel as guilty.
What?
Huh?
Because?
If you had been positive it was Mew, then you could have done something sooner. You could have prevented her death, you know.
That's...
Hey.
That's just speculation, Kokichi. You can't judge in hindsight.
My bad.
Oh, we went a little off topic there. Anyway, I wanted to ask you something. What did you do after you thought you saw Mew?
I thought I was mistaken, but it really bothered me, so... About 10 minutes later, I told Suichi, and while we were talking about it...
Ah!
What? What was that sound?
It sounded as if something was struck very hard. It came from outside, but...
We heard a loud noise and rushed out to the entrance hall. For now, let's go outside and check.
Oh no! What?
That was Kimo's voice, right? I think I heard him outside. He sounded close.
Kimo's voice, huh? Wasn't he at the chapel?
Okay. He was, but Smoogie and I are positive it was his voice. We heard Kimo from the entrance hall, where he should have been at the chapel. What?
That's weird, because you shouldn't have been able to hear anything between the chapel and the mansion.
Even you said that. A lot of flashbacks in this one conversation. Yeah, you can't hear anything at all. Oh, wait, inside the map loading point. But that's why you're in the map loading point.
I see.
You're right. The sound suddenly reached through the map loading point. So how did we hear Kimo's voice? How were we able to hear Kimo in the mansion if he was at the chapel?
Maybe someone's lying.
What?
Lying.
Hey.
By the way, Kokichi, did you hear the loud noise or Kimo's voice at all?
Ah.
I'm not sure. I must not have noticed because I was too busy searching.
You're lying to his face! Kaito. Kaito! You keep interrupting me when I talk. Do you like me or something?
Don't
fool around! Who would like you, dumbass? I was interested in Suichi's conversation!
Huh? My conversation?
You heard Kilo's voice when it's sort of impossible! Can you tell me more about that?
Well, what I said before was pretty much everything. After that, we headed back to the chapel to see what happened.
We saw Gante as we left the mansion, and the three of us went to the river together. That's when we met up with Kokichi.
Yeah.
And then we used the signboard that I found as a bridge. What about it, though? Did you notice anything?
I suppose not.
But...
I see you working hard. It looks like you're starting to take the game seriously, Kaito.
Alright. Smoogie's account has been added. Loud noise has been added. Alright, I'm gonna save, because I don't know when this game will crash. I wonder, do we have any more dress-up things? Nope, we have to buy all of those. Okay, just making sure. Alright, let's start with Kibo about that. I've been wondering, what if the secret of the outside- what was the secret of the outside world that we were searching for anyway? That's true. We got sidetracked by Mew's murder case. We never discovered what that secret actually was. We couldn't find anything at the chapel, and you found nothing at the mansion, right? No, Smoogie and I didn't find anything.
Not bad.
I didn't find anything either. That's probably the same with Kaito and Gonta too, right?
Right?
And knowing them, if they had found something, they would have told us right away.
Yeah.
Yes, they would have, unlike you.
What?
Wow, Sweetie, did you hear that? The robot's being sassy with me. Did you know? Robots don't need warm blood to function, so they become cold like this. That's why he's more concerned about the secret of the outside world than poor Mew. He told us he couldn't cry even if he wanted to. He went so far to stage his dramatic reaction.
That's wrong.
That's not true. I'm hoping we can discover the truth too.
Oh.
You're a pretty advanced robot. You can be sassy and make excuses. Grr.
Okay, so we're not getting anything from him. Alright, Kokichi, talk to us.
You don't have to be so wary of me. I'm keeping an eye out, in case Kaito tries to bother you.
It's true!
Don't try to take it the wrong way, though. I'm not trying to replace Kaito as your partner, okay? But I'll help you as much as I can. So, where are you gonna investigate now?
What is he trying to do? Why does he insist on following me around? Alright, Maki, tell us about what happened over at the chapel. Maki was working on the computer, her hand moving the mouse around rapidly. You know how to work that computer, Maki?
No.
No, not really. I've never used this program before either. I see. I imagine it would be difficult to understand unless you weren't an expert. But I did find the text file regarding this program. It has info about the program's basic features, but other than that, there's not much.
Oh,
so what did it say? If you don't want to tell me, at least tell it to Suichi.
According to this text file, the Killing Game Simulator used a certain program as the base. It's called Neo World Program.
Neo World Program? Never heard of it.
Well...
In this Killing Game Simulator, objects can't break. Your body's five senses are connected to your avatar, and your avatar cannot be harmed. But any damage inflicted on your avatar will be transferred to your body in the real world.
That matches what Mew told us.
That's true.
If your avatar receives fatal damage, then your real body will die from shock.
Huh?
From shock?
Oh.
Ooh, this is the first time we're hearing about this. If someone receives a fatal injury in the virtual world, then they'll die in the real world.
Hmm.
Well, your five senses are connected, so it makes sense you'd feel the same amount of pain. So, it wouldn't be too surprising if you died from the fatal injury.
Oh, man.
But the more important question is, why didn't you keep such an important detail a secret? Huh, maybe because if nobody had the inclination that you could die, no one would have the inclination to kill someone. That is strange. I have no idea why she wouldn't mention such an important detail. Did she hide that from us on purpose?
Well...
that's all it says about the virtual world's basic features. The rest of the virtual world is the same as the real world, including the laws of physics. Warps and special transportation, like mounts, do not exist.
I see.
So you can only move around using your avatar.
Oh,
wow. She should have added warps and mounts to the virtual world. That's all it says in this text file.
Thank you.
Thank you, Maki. That was very helpful. Alright, simulator has been...
what?
Killing game simulator has been added. But is the info in this text file correct?
What are you talking about?
What do you mean?
Nuh-uh.
I'm not doubting you or anything, Maki. But I'm just saying that this file could have been rewritten. It's possible someone rewrote the original info with false info, you know.
But
to determine that, you would need extensive knowledge of computers.
It's my time to shine!
This looks like a job for me!
Huh?
What?
What?
Huh?
Stop it.
Don't get in our way.
I won't get in the way! In fact, I want you to let me help with the investigation!
Oh, help with the investigation? Monitor, what are you saying?
Hey!
Come on, please! Won't you let me help with the investigation? Ever since I forgot I'm bad with computers, I'm good with computers now!
Right now, you're on the
threat. That's not how that works!
What are you talking about?
That logic doesn't make any sense.
No way!
You can't, Monitor! We're not allowed to help the participants. As mascots, we gotta stick to that rule.
I don't care.
I don't give a fart about the rules. I want to help everyone. I want to avenge my dead mommy.
Huh?
Your mommy. You mean you.
Mother.
No, Monitor. You've forgotten again. You've forgotten that she's not our mother.
I want you.
And you've forgotten about the important person you need to protect.
Shut up, you pig. I'm busy avenging Mommy's death!
No, how sad, but it looks like this is goodbye. I love you, but there's someone I need to protect. Goodbye.
So long, farewell.
Huh. Alrighty then, let's do this.
Huh? Do what?
So what?
I don't care either way. If you want to help, then that's fine. It's true, I suppose, but...
Thanks!
I'll do my best, for mommy's sake!
No.
Wait, perhaps we should... He's doing as much for his dead mommy! I'm so tired. Alright, fine. I'll leave it to you then. I suppose I have no choice.
Alright!
Alright! I'll start Analyzing the computer right away!
Yeah! Is he just rapidly button mashing?
This stinky little computer is no match for my hands!
Yeah. His hands are growing at such an intense speed that the friction is creating fire!
Alright!
I've already analyzed a few things!
Already?
Okay.
The text file is consistent with the original program. It doesn't look like it was altered.
Yay!
Also, I found this too!
Is this...
this looks like the information of when everyone logged in and out.
Okay.
There's no sign that this was altered either. It's definitely accurate information.
Hey.
Could you show it to me? This is important. It really does have everyone's log in and log out times recorded. Okay, let's see. So the login thing is consistent with how we logged in. Kaito logged out at 5:17. Then Kibo, Himiko, and Maki logged out at 6:55. So they logged out before Miyu was killed. after Mew was killed. So the only way they could have killed her is if they were, if they killed her while in the virtual world. And those three were also the ones at the chapel. It was those three specifically at the chapel. So it might make sense that they went out first. And they seem like a heavy rush to get out. So it's possible that they, one of them killed her. Though Kaido logging out does seem suspicious.
Well,
aside from Mew, everyone logged in and out once.
You're right.
Then it would appear that no one secretly logged out and then logged back in. Then my main concern becomes, Kaito, he logged out ahead of us. No, it couldn't be him. Also, there's something else I noticed while I was analyzing the program.
Sir.
It looks like some parts of the program were rewritten.
Huh?
The program's been rewritten. Obviously, Mew was the only person capable of doing that. So, which file did he rewrite? And what did he change?
Okay.
I'll analyze that, of course. But it's gonna take a little time.
Yeah.
Well, as long as it's done by the class trial, then Sweetie will be able to avenge Mew. He's just saying whatever he pleases.
Alright!
Alright! Then I'll keep on analyzing the crap out of this program! You're so reliable.
That's true.
Yeah, way more than you.
Ooh, savage! Gonna save again. Alright, Kaido, I need to hear from you.
That's
what?
Right.
Suichi, I gotta explain! Just so you don't misunderstand! Explain what? You're talking about how you logged out by yourself, right? Okay, let's hear it then.
What?
Well, why are you?
Yeah.
Feel free to lie, of course. Explosion lies is the real pleasure of this game, after all.
Don't screw around!
Oh! What?
Hey!
Kaido, just ignore him and talk to me, okay?
I mean,
how about the whole logging out thing? I don't really get it myself. Well, looking for a secret of the outside world on the rooftop, circling up under me. I was suddenly sucked in, and before I knew it, I was logged out.
The same thing happened when I used a phone to log out. How did that happen on the roof? And what happened after you logged out?
So
everyone else was still logged in, but I didn't know if it was okay for me to log back in. So I just went to my room and slept! Since it was dawn, I was pretty tired!
And the body discovery announcement woke you.
Okay.
Yeah, that's right! I heard it and rushed back here!
Hey!
Do you remember what condition Mew's body was in when you logged out?
My bad.
No, I didn't pay attention to that, so I don't know! You didn't notice anything wrong, like whether she was dead or not. Like I said, I don't know! Okay, sorry. So, I just need to object to the contradiction of that testimony, right? References!
Don't screw around!
I said I'm lying! Tell him, Suichi!
Suichi!
No, Suichi. In order to find the truth, he can't be biased.
He seemed pretty adamant about trying to, force Kaido to be the culprit. Alright, Himiko, please tell us about what happened over at the chapel.
I never thought you would be killed. When I saw her avatar there, not moving, I thought maybe, but
you're right.
That's right. You saw that Mew's avatar in the virtual world and stopped moving.
Me, Kibo, and Maki all found her avatar.
Hey!
Can you tell me more about that? Any details?
We were looking for the secret of the outside world at the chapel.
Hey!
Mew was too, right?
No.
No, Mew volunteered to look around the outside of the chapel, so she wasn't with us.
Mew volunteered to look around outside.
We searched, but we couldn't find anything. Then right when we were starting to get tired, all of a sudden, we heard a really loud sound outside.
Really? You heard the sound too. That must be the sound I heard as well.
Something must have hit the wall of the chapel really hard. We found it all the way from inside.
Something hitting the chapel wall.
So we all rushed outside to check the side of the chapel, and we found Mew's avatar.
That's when you went to log out, to check Mew's real body, correct?
But
when we went to the river, the bridge was gone for some reason. Then while we were standing around wondering what to do, you guys showed up.
Thank you.
I see. Thank you.
Oh.
That testimony sounded important, especially about how they couldn't cross the river.
Because?
Because if they weren't able to cross the river, then no one could have gone between the mansion and the chapel. Then this helps us narrow down the people who could have come into contact with Mew.
Who could have come into contact with Mew at the chapel. The vents at the chapel have been added. Alright, last one to talk to. Gonto!
Hey!
Gonto, oh, you're right.
You're so dumb.
Oh, you're still depressed about Mew. Come on, don't be a Debbie Downer.
By the way.
Oh, Gonto, I want to know what you think. Rare, I know. But who do you think is the culprit?
Gonto don't know.
Gonto not sure. Murder only happened when Gonto wake up.
How this
but
happened?
Why this happened? Why Mew killed? Gonto not understand. Gonto not understand anything.
Something must be.
But Gonto frustrated and sad. Gonto no could protect Mew. He seems all over the place right now. Aw, oh, man. He can't think at all when he's like this.
It's true!
But Gonto doesn't seem to be lying. I'm pretty sure he's telling us the truth. Well, I guess a big dum-dum like Gonto doesn't have the brains to lie in the first place.
Hey!
Don't talk about him like that.
I'm disappointed.
I'm so disappointed in you, Gonto. When I first met you, I thought you'd be more useful.
Sorry!
Sorry!
Gonto,
so sorry! Gonto, sorry, he no could protect Mew! Gonto.
Hey!
If you feel that bad about it, then stop blaming yourself. Help us find the culprit instead. This is the culprit's fault anyway. So pull yourself together and help us, okay? Okay, Gonto understand.
Gonto do his best.
Gonto do his best to find culprit. Gonto definitely do his best this time.
Yeah.
Yeah, now that's the spirit.
Now Kokichi is encouraging him. I really don't know what Kokichi is thinking. I suppose I've investigated everything that I can here.
Hey!
Oh, you're not investigating the crime scene yet? Crime scene? So, do you know who the culprit is yet?
No.
No. This might not actually be the crime scene. Yes, injuries in the real world could be fatal in the real world. Injuries in the virtual world can be fatal in the real world. Meaning there's a possibility that she was killed in the virtual world. Which means the next area to investigate should be...
Oh, I see.
The virtual world. We should go there again.
Huh?
Huh?
See?
I just read your mind, didn't I? I did right.
Got it.
Who's the staircase that I'm coming to?
Oh?
Oh, great. He's coming. You must really like me, huh?
Yeah.
Say whatever you want! I don't have time to waste on you!
Yeah.
If we go back to the virtual world, we might find some new clues! With those, I might be able to clear my name! May I join you as well? I also think we should investigate the virtual world again!
Alright!
Well, we'll go!
Oh, so I get to be that avatar again.
What? Huh? Did you actually like the avatar after all?
Well...
I'm going to stay here. He's still in the middle of analyzing the program.
Hmm.
Gonto, search this place some more! It's no time to be sleeping!
That's not what we're... Well, that's fine.
Then I'll stay here too.
Huh?
What?
Surprised. Are you gonna get lonely without your partner?
My bad.
But I'm busy too, you know. I have to watch Maki, in case he tries to do anything deceitful.
Huh?
Deceitful?
See?
Well, you and Kaido are pretty close, so you might do something deceitful for him, right?
Thank goodness.
Yes.
Good thing Gonta's here with me. Your glare is too scary to handle alone. Gonta would risk his life to protect me from a murderer.
Huh?
Huh? Ah! Hey, if you keep messing up, if you keep saying messed up crap like that, I'm gonna kick your ass in orbit!
Alright, already.
It's fine. Just ignore him and hurry to the virtual world.
Okay. Kaido, let's just focus on solving the case for now. Fine! Thank God. I don't like violence. The ultimate supreme leader would rather sneak around.
So that means...
So anyway, I'll leave the virtual world to you, Shuichi.
Yeah.
But I'm not exaggerating when I say this class trial can only be solved by you, okay? Your talent can save the useless people here, you know.
Huh?
Who are you calling useless?
I told you.
Enough already.
Kaido, let's go.
Kaido, Kibo, Himiko, Tsumugi, and I prepare to enter the virtual world. We pick up our helmets once again, sitting in the same seats as before.
So the red cord goes in the right side and the blue cord in the left, yeah?
Yeah, let's do that.
Right is the hand I hold my chopsticks with. I gotta be sure to get it right.
If you're that worried, why don't you use one that's already set up?
We place the devices on our heads and flip the switch. Logging in! Huh, there wasn't that much audio delay that time. I mean, I guess it makes sense because it wasn't really too visually intensive. It doesn't look like I had any encoding error with that, too.
Great, huh?
Oh, it's my avatar. Look, my avatar.
So, you liked it after all?
You know...
So we're back here!
100%.
Apparently we always arrive in this room when we log in.
Hmm. You said that logging in and out isn't possible unless we're in this room.
Then how did I get logged out while I was on the rooftop?
Okay.
Yes, we need to investigate that area too.
What should we do?
First we're going to check Mew's avatar, right?
That's right.
I think our avatar is still near the chapel.
Then let's head out to the chapel.
Did it occur to no one that because you took off Mew's helmet, that, you know, her avatar might actually be logged out by now? Did that occur to none of you? Well, I guess not. There's nothing really to investigate up here. We can only look at the sparkly things. Can't look at anything else. Ah, I should check the map before I leave the chapel. Why do we need to relook at the map? The two maps on the wall, one of the mansion, one of the worlds. I'll check the map of the mansion first. The first floor has the salon, dining room, kitchen, and bathroom. The second is the roof. We split up when looking for the secret of the outside world. Kokichi at the salon, Tsumugi the dining room, Kaido the roof, and Gonta the outside. And I had the kitchen. This is the map of the entire virtual world. The world was surrounded by walls in all four directions. There's a loading point in the middle, so the map is split in two. No sight or sound can pass through the map loading point. To get from the mansion to the chapel, you have to go through this point. You also have to cross the river that runs parallel to it. That's how the world was designed. That's how the world is designed. It's strange. I feel as though there's some secret to this. This map was made by Mew. Is that what's bothering me?
Hey, Shuichi.
I understand. Looking at maps makes you feel calm, doesn't it? You're the type of kid who stands at maps alone instead of playing at recess, aren't you?
No.
I never did anything like that.
Shuichi! Don't forget we're here for you, bro!
indeed.
You're not alone anymore.
That's fine.
You don't need to withdraw into a cell, you know.
What? I'm so proud of you. You made friends with real people, not maps.
What's wrong?
I'm investigating. Just investigating. Okay. First, I should enter the temple. Come on! Let me freaking investigate how I want to investigate. Ugh. Oh, Sir AJ, could you please come with me?
What happened?
What happened? I found something strange. I don't know if it's relevant to the case, but I want to hear your opinion regardless. It's right this way. This is toilet paper, right? Why would it be in a place like this?
That's right.
It's cold here.
Huh?
Huh?
Which means...
My initial thought was that someone may have come here to defecate.
No.
No, I don't think that's it. I don't think the avatars have bowel movements. I don't have to go at all.
Huh?
I didn't realize that. That never occurred to me, and I do not need to expel solid waste in the real world. I'm sorry. Oh, wait.
But
it's still strange. Why would toilet paper be in a place like this? Could it be related to the case? And because nothing breaks, it's possible you could use that as like a repel. Alright, so there's nothing else. Let's look around. Nothing really around here. And the bridge is still there. There's something important to note. Because if you look at the map closely, map of the world, if you look closely, it looks like the map just sort of loops itself around. It definitely looks like it loops around, so it might be possible to go from one edge to the other. Do some like gap or something that you never told us about. There's nothing that I can click on. Alright, let's just go across. Get a look at the bridge first.
Hey, so...
Hey! Isn't that the signboard that Mule threw into the river? Whoops, my hand slipped. It's not similar signboard, right? She said there's only one of them!
No.
It's definitely the same. I brought back the one that was stuck on the rock in the river.
Ah.
Oh, so that's what happened!
But
there's something bothering me. The rock on that signboard got caught on weren't on the chapel side of the map. They were on the mansion side.
What about that bothers you? It got washed from the chapel to the mansion, right?
From the chapel to the mansion? That's odd. The flow of the river...
Shuichi!
Think about it later, bro! Let's get moving! Alright, for now we need to investigate the scene. Alright, signboard used as a bridge has been added. Nothing up here. Still nothing really down here. Nothing. No other way to really get over. Up. Ha! Huh. The scene of the crime has not been altered since I found her. So there's no possibility that someone tried to tamper with the crime scene afterwards.
Yeah, that's for sure. It's just like how we left it. I'm pretty confident in my memory. I memorized a magic spell that would take a whole year just to chant.
What?
If you think I'm lying, I could start the chant right now, you know.
No, thank you. I do not think I could wait a whole year. A logged out avatar disappears, but if the real body dies, the avatar remains unchanged.
Actually,
look at all this stuff scattered around. What happened here?
That's what we're gonna start investigating right now! Isn't that right, Suichi?
Okay.
Right.
Alright. Hammer. This is a hammer. Why would there be a hammer in this world?
I rewrote the program to delete outdated objects to be used as weapons.
You said she deleted dangerous objects. I can't imagine she'd miss a hammer. Was me lying, but why would she lie? Alright, hammer has been added. Resistant. Is this a cell phone? There are cell phones in this world, but what could they be for?
No.
Ah, that's it! It's a phone, so...
A cell phone! I can't believe there's something like this here!
Kaido, perfect timing. I'd like you to help me out with something. I just want to test something out.
Come on, man.
Help you out!
Of course!
Of course! I know a favor for my sidekick!
Thank you.
Thank you, Kaido.
You know...
So, what do you need me to do?
Is that alright?
Ah, you don't have anything. I have to do anything. You just have to stand here.
I just gotta stand here!
Kaito Momota. He logged out, just as I thought. This can be used to log out, just like the phone in the salon. But it doesn't have to be you saying it. And this proves that it doesn't have to be the person themselves. If you just say their name, you can log out anyone you like.
Alright.
I see. Thanks to Kaido's help, I'm starting to pin this down. Okay. I bet Kaido was pretty surprised when he logged out all of a sudden. I should apologize for that later. Is this a piece of lattice? Why is this here? Last time we saw that was in a storage room up on the roof on the mansion side.
Yeah, that is a mysterious object.
It's a wooden mat. It's used to be common in bathrooms.
I didn't see anything like it at the chapel. Where did it come from?
Not from the chapel. Then why is it here?
Yeah, I just figured it out with my magic.
Huh? You did?
I see.
Maybe someone used that instead of the signboard to cross the river. That someone is the culprit.
No.
I don't think so. That river's current is pretty fast. Even if you did use it to cross, there's no reason it would be here.
I know that. I was just testing you a little.
Why would you want to test me?
But what does that mean? What's something like this doing here?
I'm not positive why this lattice is left here, but I'm sure it must have something to do with the case. Alright, I'm gonna save quick. Now I wonder, is there a separate log for that? Cell phone. There's still no way.
Actually.
Oh, that reminds me. You can't leave footprints in the snow, can you?
You're right.
It looks that way. This is a killing game simulator.
Yeah.
It's probably because footprints in the snow would make finding the culprit easy. The snow probably isn't a clue for this case.
So, there's still no way to really get through, unless there's something inside the chapel. Alright, so let's actually look at Mew's body. Mew's avatar is frozen, collapsed in the snow. A logged-out avatar disappears, but if the real body dies, the avatar remains. Makes sense for a killing game simulator. If the body disappeared, we couldn't investigate. The avatars never show injuries, so they stay the same. She still looks almost alive.
What?
Her face is so pretty here, isn't it? It's hard to believe she's dead.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, we just get our avatar. That's it? Okay.
Hey,
Himiko, can you tell me about when you found Mew one more time?
Yeah, we were looking for the secret of the outside world at the chapel. But since Mew volunteered to check outside the chapel, she was separate from us. After a while, when we started the search, we heard a really loud sound outside. Something must have hit the wall of the chapel really hard. We all felt it from way all the way from inside. Something hit the jungle wall. So we all rushed out to check the site of the chapel. And we found Mir's avatar. And then we all tried to go to the mansion to log out and check Mir's real body. But when we got to the river, the bridge was gone for some reason. And then while we were standing around wondering what to do, you guys showed up.
Thank you.
Thank you, I got it. Must be some clue to that account. Alright, Kibo. What's wrong, Kibo? Is something bothering you?
Well...
I just remembered something! I think the whispering I heard, I overheard might be relevant to this case. You think? You heard whispering?
Yes.
Yes, I did not intend to eavesdrop, but I did hear it. So right before we gathered at the chapel, and they're supposed to begin searching. Oh yeah, before we split up, I want to ask you something, Mew. It would seem Kokichi and Mew had made plans to meet each other.
Huh?
Meet each other?
Yes.
Kokichi was confirming the specific place they were supposed to meet. I couldn't hear the whole conversation, but I'm certain the rooftop was mentioned.
Then
those two met on the rooftop.
Well...
But it's strange, right? If they were planning to meet on the mansion's rooftop, why did Mew volunteer to search the area around the chapel?
You're right.
That's true. If they were meeting on the roof, she would have wanted to search the mansion. Either way, she shouldn't have been able to get to the rooftop. She was searching the area around the chapel, which is where we found her avatar. And with the bridge you crossed the river, she could not have gone from the chapel to the mansion. That's true. Something is strange about all of this. Alright. You and Kokichi's meeting at the net. Okay, I finished my investigation of this area.
Shuichi!
Shuichi, it would appear that we're finished investigating this place.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, there's something I want to ask. Can our avatars hide objects?
It seems you can put stuff in your clothes here too. Just like the real world.
I see. Just like the real world.
Yeah.
So, what are we gonna do next? Are we going back to the real world already? Before that, there's one more place I have to investigate. The mansion rooftop.
As I thought.
Very well then. The place Mew and Kokichi were supposed to meet out. The place Kaido logged out. I'm positive it has something to do with the case. There should be clues there.
I don't really get it, but if you want to investigate, then let's go do that, Shuichi.
Shuichi, everyone is counting on you, including myself.
Shuichi!
Please give the Castrol everything you've got and see us through to the end. And I will do my best as well, of course.
And I as well. I can at least do that. I'm a detective after all.
I wonder if Kibo's robot functions work here.
Let me investigate places.
So I wonder if, like, Kibo would be able to, use his photographic thing. His photographic memory. I mean, it's literally photographic memory. What if he'd be able to use that to, in here? Alright, let's go check out the rooftop.
Shuichi!
Hey, Shuichi! What was that all about?
Sorry.
Kaido, I'm sorry. I just wanted to see if you could log out using the cell phone.
Then tell me first! That was bad for my heart! Alright, so we got logged out! I've panicked and rushed back here!
Sorry.
Stop it.
Oh, come now. Come on now. That's enough. Don't interfere with the investigation.
You know...
I wasn't interfering! Wait, why did you guys come back here? Did you already finish investigating? I wanted to investigate the rooftop next. Huh? What's important about the rooftop? Was it Mew at the top of the whole time? We found her on the ground next to it!
Now, let's believe in Shuichi's reasoning.
It'll be okay.
Shuichi can do it for sure. He's the ultimate detective after all.
If you're gonna be like that, then do what you want! Investigate the rooftop or whatever! But Shuichi is my sidekick! In other words, his deductions are my deductions! And my deductions are his!
Hey now!
What are you, some credit-stealing bully?
Well,
I'm gonna miss Game Muse Avatar since I got interrupted last time!
Sorry. Well then.
Well then, let's go to the rooftop!
Yeah,
we should!
I wanna look at the... Time could be up soon, I should hurry to the rooftop. Come on! Let me investigate what I wanna investigate! The toilet paper clearly came from the bathroom room, so I wanna see if there are any clues in there! Game, please, let me investigate! I'm a detective, dammit!
Peachy and Mew were supposed to meet on this very rooftop. And the person in charge of searching this area, Kaito, was forcibly locked out.
That's true.
This area must have something to do with the case. I'm gonna look at the storage. The storage room. It's a little different than I remember. It feels as if something is missing. And there would be that little lattice thing. It feels as if something is missing. But I wasn't paying close enough attention the first time, so I don't remember. The only thing missing is that lattice thing, so nothing there. Alright, let's look through those binoculars. Might not be directly connected to the case, but I should inspect these binoculars. I can see that this building is on top of a hill. I can't see past this point because it's the map loading point. But that is strange. Why would the map loading point be right in the middle of the world? Something doesn't seem right. That's it? Alright. Kibo, did you find anything?
This is difficult. There's nothing here that seems to resemble a clue. But Mew should have a race to meet with Kokichi here. I thought we could confirm whether or not she really came to the rooftop. But unfortunately, there are no clues which indicate that.
Did Mew ever come to the roof? That is an important question. Hey Kiba, I wanted your opinion on something. Do you think you can get up and down from the roof outside the mansion?
No,
that would have been very difficult. This rooftop is rather high. Even the edge of the roof is roughly the height of a 3-to-4-story building.
You're right.
Yes, certainly too high to jump.
Yes, I thought.
Which means it would have been impossible to climb from the outside.
That means that the only way up to this rooftop is the stairs. Okay, Himiko. What's wrong, Himiko?
When murders happen in a mansion in the snow like this, there are always locked room mysteries created up by piled up snow, isn't that right? But it's disappointing that you can't leave footprints on the snow in this world.
Is that something to be disappointed about? What happens? Do you just like step over the snow or something? Alright, anyone left? Don't give me
I see.
Hey.
What's wrong, Samugi?
Look at the door now. It's locked.
What? It is. It's a thumb turn lock. Easy to lock.
It seems you can't lock it unless you're on the outside. And look, the keyhole is on this side of the door. Isn't it usually the other way around?
No.
Not necessarily. I've seen this before. It's to prevent you from locking yourself out.
I see.
Is that so?
This rooftop has a lock on the door. That is important information. I've inspected everything here, and all that's left now is... Whoa, hey, whoa, Maki, why are you here?
Oh, there you are. I was looking for you.
Huh? Maki, why are you here? I thought you were analyzing the program.
I told you.
Monotaro finished analyzing the program, so he told me to gather everyone.
He finished!
Shuichi!
We should probably head back then. Our investigation here is pretty much done, right?
Okay.
Yeah, you're right. I've investigated everything I needed to.
Shuichi!
Well then, we'll head back first.
I don't wanna
say goodbye to my avatar.
Did you like it that much?
then...
We should go too.
Hey!
What's wrong?
You.
Well, you're definitely more reliable in a class trial than out. All the others think so too.
Huh?
What?
Well...
I'm not trying to sound like Kaido, but... I don't think you should carry that burden alone. Yosuichi's Sayahara before you're a detective. Don't ever forget that. Well, I shouldn't be talking. I threw away my identity as Maki Harukawa to be an assassin.
Thank you.
Thank you, Maki. Also, why were you mad at us? Tell us! Was he being considerate just now? Also, we should probably go get Kaito. Also, let me investigate places! Curious as to his own monitor's investigation, I still log out from the salon. Fine. Forcing me. You can railroad it, man. It's just you and me. We should log out too.
By the way,
did something happen between you and Kaido?
Huh?
What?
Well...
When he logged out a little while ago, he looked like he was in a bad mood.
Sorry.
I'm sorry, that's probably my fault. Alright. Suichi Sayahara. I pulled the device off my head, and the real world appeared before me.
Shuichi!
Well, Shuichi, isn't the real world way better than some virtual reality? Anyway, I felt so lonely without you around. Apologize for making me feel unloved.
Hey,
there's something I wanted to ask you. I totally didn't draw anything when you told me why you were logged in, okay?
Huh?
What?
It's a lie.
I'm kidding. So, what was it you wanted to ask?
Is that alright?
You planned to meet with me on the roof, right? Did you end up meeting her? Oh, so you know about that, Shuichi. Impressive, Mr. Ultimate Detective.
Okay,
then, I'll tell you what happened. I never met up with Mew. I couldn't get to the rooftop because it was locked.
Huh?
Locked? After, I gave up and went back to searching the salon to search for the secret of the outside world. Is that true, Kokichi?
Mm-hmm.
Are you doubting me?
That's...
Someone verify that you were at the salon the entire time. Did you meet anyone there?
Mm.
No, I don't have a witness.
Right?
But you can also tell me I was no witness to prove I wasn't there.
Hey!
Unless you saw the salon empty yourself.
Anyway...
Well, it's up to you whether or not you want to believe me or not.
Shuichi!
But you shouldn't doubt me like that. We're partners. Which one is it? Did Kokichi meet with me or not? Is he lying or telling the truth? Which is it? Alright. Okay. Let's save quick. Talk with Monitor.
Hey!
I've been waiting for you, Suichi! I'm sure Maki already told you, but I finally finished analyzing Rugram!
Okay.
I'm starting to put together a lot of important facts, so here they are!
He really is trying to be our friend. A little bit, at least.
Sir.
First, the person you championed with this program was Mommy, like we suspected. Mommy has an eccentric way of writing her code, so I knew it was her right away!
I guess her personality was the only eccentric thing about her.
Got a minute?
So what did she tamper with?
A few things, but I'll share the first one with you.
So?
It looks like Mommy deleted a lot of objects from this killing game simulator.
She said that she deleted anything that could be used as a weapon. But in that case, why is there a hammer?
Okay.
That's true. Only the hammer was left. But why was it left? The way the program was written makes it seem like she did it on purpose.
On purpose?
Then...
Did she add anything? We found a cell phone in the virtual world.
Nope! That cell phone was an original feature of the program!
Then Pride Mew hid the fact from that. Hid that fact from us, which means...
All Mommy added were the two maps! The rest of the rest was already part of the program!
By the way,
while we're talking about objects, I wanted to ask you something. We used a signboard to cross the river, but could we have used something else as a bridge?
I don't really see anything that could have been used as a bridge to cross the river!
So only that signboard could have been used as a bridge. So, what's the next thing she tampered with?
Okie dokie!
Well, it looks like she also tampered with certain parameters of the program!
Huh? Parameters?
Everything in that program is categorized as either a human or a non-human object.
Of course,
everyone's avatar was assigned a human parameter.
Really?
But for some reason, Mommy gave her avatar the non-human object parameter.
And what happens when you become an object?
Well, the difference is only for identification purposes. So it probably didn't affect anything.
But if it didn't affect anything, then why would she have gone out of her way to do that?
Perhaps it has something to do with the next thing she tampered with.
So,
Mommy added a wall that didn't originally exist in the program.
Oh.
The coordinates of the virtual world are represented on an X and Y axis. And it seems Mommy added a wall that runs the length of the Y axis.
She created an additional wall. There were walls in all four directions, and two down the y-axis.
Hey!
But you're positive there was only one.
Okay!
Yeah! It's definitely the only one!
What does that mean? Which wall was the one you added? What was the world like originally? You said there wasn't anything past the wall. Huh. Was that another lie?
Also, it looks like that wall was given a special setting. A setting that allows non-human objects to pass through it.
Oh, so that's how Mew could get through. It allows objects through.
I see.
That's very interesting.
Hey.
So, are those all the things he tampered with?
Oh, there's one more thing.
So,
one of you guys had a strange setting given to their avatar.
Huh? A strange setting?
Okay.
Yeah. The setting made it so that they would be unable to move if Mommy touched them.
Interesting.
Then?
So if you touched them, their avatar would be paralyzed.
Who was it?
It was Gokichi!
It's me. I didn't know that. But I wouldn't know. I never touched Mew in that world. I see. I didn't even notice. So Mew brought us there to kill Kokichi?
Okie dokie!
That's all I have to report! Well, do you think it'll help you guys out?
Okay.
That helps a lot. Thanks. Alright, Mew's avatar has been updated. Wall added has been updated. Added. Setting on Kokichi has been added.
Oh! I should probably tell you this, too! Though it's probably not related to the case!
So?
Some sort of avatar user error occurred when you all logged in for the first time.
Error.
The contents of the error are unknown, so I can't provide any details. But something strange definitely happened to someone's avatar when you all logged in.
Well,
I don't think anyone's avatar was acting strange, though. What kind of error could it be? That's important information. So someone probably had their cord switched.
Stands in a circle and talks about the dead body.
Aw, why is Monokuma so sad?
Low energy?
Me?
No, I'm excited. Really. I'm just taking a little break right now. When I'm dead, I'll be my usual energized self. Yep, I'll be way more energized. Anyway, that's all.
Okay.
You seem like you're not into it at all. We don't have to do the class trial, you know.
What? It gonna start, huh? We no can stop it anymore.
You're right.
No, we can't.
So?
This is all I can tell you guys, but I don't want any of you to forget. I'm your friend.
What?
Huh? He just decided we're friends?
Thank you.
Thank you! Gonta feel relieved! Don't worry, Monotaro. Shuichi will get revenge for Mew's death.
It's so mean.
And he'll get that revenge by finding the culprit among us. He's right. The culprit is someone here.
Thanks!
Thank you, everyone! Thank you so much! When this class trial is over, I hope we can all get to know each other better!
It's a shame you're probably going to die.
Yeah. That's the kind of line that triggers a death flag.
Okay.
I want a fresh start. I want to make up for my past mistakes.
Wait.
That too.
I...
Meeting you all has really...
Sorry.
Sorry, it's nothing. I'll save it for after the class trial is finished.
Yeah?
Yeah, the flag is rising.
Hmm?
What was that? I think I heard something over there.
Alright!
I'll go check it out by myself!
So long, farewell!
And then he died.
What did you say?
It's waving in the wind.
This is stupid.
Quit screwing around. Let's hurry up and go.
Gotta do his best!
Gotta do his best too! Gotta do his best to be even little bit useful for everyone!
Wow!
I'm so excited. I'll definitely expose the culprit this time. What's so exciting about this? With conflicting emotions in our heart, we headed to the Shrine of Judgment. Mew's hands were clasped around her neck as if she were gasping for air. Eyes wide open in a panic. Person who found it was Kibo. She still had her helmet on at the time. Still, what caused her to suffer like this? What was the cause of death? Would you like to leave? Yes.
Look at her freaking eyes! See if she has bloodshot eyes or not! That tells you if she was poisoned!
Why would you not just look at her eyes, Shuichi?
Seriously, that's like kinda critical information right there.
Wait, the truth bullet doesn't actually say anything about it, right? Nope, it doesn't say anything about it.
I'm still sad that Mew had to die.
There are the stairs. And I don't really have a clear idea about who the culprit is. only 9 of us. Well, 8 of us now. It looks like that's everyone.
Yeah.
Oh, this everyone, huh? There are a lot less of us now.
It's plain to see.
This is just half of what we started with.
Unfortunately.
Because we've allowed this game to continue, we must stop it somehow.
Right?
But we can't stop now. We can't let the fun end. Cut it out! I'm certain this trial will be the last one!
Hey.
Let's focus on surviving this class trial first.
I guess.
You're right. If we mess up here, our numbers will go down even quicker. It'll be just the culprit left.
But...
that might be okay. Maybe that's just another way to stop the killing game. If we all die, then the killing game would end.
What?
Don't say stupid crap like that! It's pointless if we all die!
Okay.
Well, we don't have to worry. We've got the ultimate detective on our side.
You're right!
Yeah! It's time for the detective to shine! Suichi, please keep up the good work.
Okay. Yeah, I'll do my best. Yeah, I have to keep it together. This is the only time my talent can shine. I'm not just saving my life. Everyone's life is on the line. If I can't find the truth here, everyone will be sacrificed. And I will never let that happen.
Come on, man.
Hey, Suichi! You're getting all tense!
Huh?
Ah, what?
I mean...
didn't I tell you before? Suichi, you don't carry the burden at all!
Get it?
And didn't I tell you not to get in the way, Kaido?
Huh?
Huh? What's your problem?
You really don't get it.
We're all relying on Suichi to carry our asses through this class trial, okay? You're like a parrot repeating the same lines over and over. You're bothering him.
Well, you know.
I think that's the most annoying thing you can do, Suichi, you know. You can do to Suichi, you know that.
Huh?
What do you mean by that? I'm not...
Kokichi, you're annoying.
Please don't.
Whoa, Kokichi was glaring at me. I was only kidding around.
Maki's glare seemed to do the trick, as Kokichi turned around, dejected.
Jeez.
Finally, the pest is gone! Thanks, Maki Roll!
Just suck it up, Kaido. Now's not the time to be bickering with each other.
Got it!
Oh, my bad! Sorry!
Kaito, I'm okay.
Hmm? Well...
I know what you wanted to say, Kaito. You don't have to worry.
I believe in you.
I see! In that case, I'll believe in you and won't say anything else!
Shuichi!
But if you have any problems, let me know! I'll help you and I'm here for you, bro!
Thank you.
Thank you, Kaido. Alright. And we will do the class trial next time! Tomorrow. So I will see you all then, 5:30. 2:07 o'clock on this channel right here. We will begin the fourth class trial and see who killed Mew, the ultimate inventor. Shout out to the Ginger Ninja Girl for joining us for the stream here in the chat. I will hopefully see you all tomorrow. So, stay safe, watch out for entering virtual realities, and to quote Angie, bye, Nara!